telos, ancient Greek, i.e. telepathy, means end, purpose, or goal, such as a teleological purpose relating to how the universe is unfolding towards a final aim or end cause. One is the cosmological question, how the universe came into being. The second is the teleological question, is it expanding into nothingness or is it oscillating back and forth? Thirdly is the ontological question, how does consciousness relate to the material and what is the role of consciousness in our own biological evolution? Fourthly is the epistemological question, what is the truth of our infinite and eternal faculties over and above the exercise of what is processed by our physical senses? This is really the crux or cross of psychology, derived from the Greek psyche for spirit or soul, and logia, the study of, particularly defined as divine reason, from which we get the word logic. The soul must have a logical reason behind all of these things. That is psychology. That is the very ancient understanding humanity had. But today we are told that if the input to your daily sense organs produce you enough serotonin and dopamine, that is a happy and rewarding life. That is the psychology of your human existence. Psychology, the divine reason of your soul, was never that for ancient humanity. Amuna, from Amun, that pre-existing ray, matter, light. Amun ray, consciousness. Also, amuna in Hebrew means faith, faithfulness, loyalty, and is associated with Canopus, the corner star of the Kaaba. Tehuti, thought, the primary ruach, is also Metatron, the archangel of Keter, and the lesser Yehu, who was Enoch, Aknuk, initiate, before his theosis, Saku, glorification. Metatron, measure throne, and Sandalphon, who was Elijah, Eliyehu, other brother, Adelphon, Aku, archangels of the Ark of the Covenant, Arun Ha-Eduth, laws of Ma'at, known as Sharim, princes. Sandalphon is the archangel of Malkuth, and also music, fon, sound, who delivers prayers, salah, to heaven, akira, according to the liturgy for Sukkot. Also known as the godfather, Sandek, he is responsible for gender. Sandalphon is the left-hand feminine cherub of the Ark of the Covenant in the Greater Key of Solomon. The Hebrew word for Egyptians, matsorim, true highest firelight persons, also from the word matsor, Hebrew for fortress. Matsorim means sound, and isthmus, a narrow passage connecting two larger parts, a land bridge forming a link between two larger areas. In anatomy, an isthmus is a bridge of tissue in the throat and the fallopian tubes. The oviductal isthmus functions as a sperm reservoir, and the thyroid isthmus regulates the heart rate, temperature, and other vital functions. An isthmus is a narrow strip of land that stretches across a body of water to connect two larger land masses. In Greek, isthmos means neck. There are over 2,000 Neteru, perceived as over 2,000 gods. Genesis 1, in the beginning, Barashit, was the Tehum of Tehuti, thought, the Ruach, royal brother, intellect. The wife, sometimes sister of Tehuti, thought, is Seshat, literally female scribe. Sesha, script. Ma'at, truth, wife of Tehuti. Seshat, script, sister of Tehuti. The written word, Rem Kemi Sesh. Meju Neteru, language M alike Ray, Rem of Kem, Egypt. Sesha, from Se, teachings, sentience. Sha, will or moment. The language of the gods can be written, Sesha, script, or thought, Tehu, respectively the netters Seshat and Tehuti. Our language is sound, telephon. Egyptian language is thought, telepath. Greek tele, pathos, patheia, the language of the gods. Meju neteru, Egyptian. Greek telepatheia, feminine for medicine. Meju neteru, neteru in Greek means gods. The heart, pathos, is the seat of intelligence, telos, and a diagnosis, dia-gnosis, is to know, gnosis, the heart of the dia, instrument, i.e. pathology, heart, knowledge.